working on the grassroots. Mental health issue, which is being, you know, normally, you know, it is being discussed a lot when it comes to, you know, police forces. I mean, it has received a lot of traction from academia also, from policymakers also, but you'll not see that, you know, the same when it comes to administration.
Hello, namaste, Johar. Welcome to What's Hot in Rural India. We have Ramesh with us. Ramesh is part of the public policy in action at TRI and currently works in Jharkhand at Gumla district. And Ramesh has extensively worked with sarpanchs, government officers, and is currently also engaging with the district administration at Gumla. Obviously, I'm going to ask you, what's hot in governance in rural India this time?
In the last couple of months, we have witnessed, you know, nationwide elections, and you'll see that, you know, there has been a very significant participation by women and people from marginalized sections. And definitely, the credit goes to, you know, people's rising aspiration, you know, plus their expectations from the government also. Another, you'll see also, you know, there has been a demand to improve the welfare services from the people also. So that has been another, I mean, very interesting, you know, trend.
I think in the last India Rural Colloquy, we saw participation of women sarpanch who came to the panel and discussed about the challenges that they face. Why do you think marginalized communities and especially women leaders feel these kind of challenges in coming forward, and why do we see lesser participation from them in governance?
While working on the grassroots, I have felt that people have been very, you know, eager, you know, when it comes to addressing their own problem. It is only that they feel that, you know, the resources that requires the access to, you know, institutions, their own, you know, social location, their geographical location, it often, you know, acts as an impediment for them. So very interesting, you know, government has allocated more than 2400 crore rupees for, you know, these extremely vulnerable groups.
We look forward to taking many more such conversations from 1 to 8 August at multiple levels in India, in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Thank you everyone who has been showing support and sending across your questions and queries. We look forward to taking these questions forward in the next session, and please let us know what would you like to hear in the next session. Thank you so much for joining us. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.